We did see this matchup at Hype Spotting not too long ago.
Okay. Who took it there? Did Luffy get
Luffy
the edge?
Luffy took it, yeah.
Okay.
It was a very close finals, though, and maybe Chris has maybe labbed the Mika matchup a bit more since that loss.
I would imagine so. I mean, when you're playing at all these tournaments and you're seeing the same top players at each one, like, you definitely want to put in your lab work, get to know the characters you're likely to face.
That's something that you have to do at this level. Being... going in the lab and doing your homework and doing your research.
It's a lot of work, and I think that's something that a lot of players, medium level players, don't do, is they'll just keep grinding out ranked matches online.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? They lose, you just hit rematch, you go.
You have to acknowledge, you have to analyze yourself and be willing to know where you went wrong. So let's see if Kobokog has done that since Hype Spotting.
Yeah. Like, I've watched Chris's stream before, and sometimes when new stuff comes out, he'll stream all day just training mode.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? He knows the importance of that. So let's say if he's labbed a little bit, he has some technology maybe against Ormeika this time. So we're going to have Luffy player one as Ormeika, and we have Kobokog player two as Kami.
That battle out with Kami.
That was a nice check.
Great answer.
That's number one against Ormeika. You have to be able to deal with that charge drop.
You have to check that drop kick, yes. Back medium punch is Kami's main answer, I believe.
Mm.
Four frames. Very quick. But if you mess up, you do get crush counter. That is not good when you have 900 HP.
And we're seeing very patient play from Kobokog here, but it has got him cornered. Nice confirm. Counter hit confirm. Gets back to mid screen and gets him some damage. He's got the life lead now.
Chris is just trying to shimmy, but Luffy is not taking the bait.
No, Luffy is going forward, and when he's on the defense, he's just blocking, getting to a safe position again so he can reassert his offense.
I mean, even though Ormeika is an offensive character, Luffy is no stranger to a lame defense style. I mean, SF4, that was his thing with Rose.
Yeah, I would say unequivocally the best Rose player in the world in Street Fighter 4.
Absolutely. World class. Here we are, Kami Corner. This is a dangerous place to be.
We have the abuse trigger.
This may kill. Grey HP, this may kill. And there you have
gosh.
It. 900 HP, boys. Nadeshko.
Deshko with the assist from off screen.
Wow.
They took out assists from Marvel, but Ormeika still has them in this game.
They gave it to Ormeika.
Yeah.
Nice confirm on the counter hit, medium punch. Bulldog.
Here we go. Alright.
Excellent confirm again.
Scrappy
it's done. This is over. That's it. First game for Luffy. So much damage.
Dominant performance for Luffy.
Perfect for Luffy. 1-0 for Luffy.
Alright guys, so yeah, we have no fear of Chris switching character here. I know we're speculating on some of these matches, but Chris is Kami for
life. Chris is gonna stick with his bae, Kami.
Here's some encouragement from the Irish cred there. Let's go, Chris. People shouting. People really want to see Kobokog do well here.
He's not answering that drop kick. That's pivotal.
He's not. He did the first time, but I think it might have almost been a coincidence because he hit it with a back medium kick counter hit.
Like you said before, that drop kick, it's an integral part of this matchup. You have to answer it.
Yeah.
And again,
blocking it again. You can't let this keep happening. Nice dash forward. Nice grab. Wow, Luffy is looking pretty confident here. He's not scared of Chris's range at all.
I think this costume pick may be a bit of a strategic push for Luffy.
Yeah, This is some Street Fighter 4 Blanka stuff right here.
Costume lag.
Blanka, yeah.
Shout out to costume lag.
Nice grab. Alright, nice dash forward from Chris. He's working hard to maintain the mid screen here. Very, very important against Mika.
Nice
firm. Oh, but he doesn't follow through with it.
Capitalize.
I'm not sure why exactly. Do you think the range was off?
I think he maybe didn't want to risk DP missing.
Yeah.
Because the only follow up you get there is a DP. So.
Yeah. I think he was just a little bit unsure. And this is his V trigger down the drain. He gets nothing off his V trigger. He got. Oh, that's the round. He almost got lucky there that the Nadeshko call hit the DP rather than a full punish, but it didn't matter.
Absolutely. Luffy looking pretty dominant here. Chris, you have to find an answer.
Oh, that was
excellent.
That was something. Again.
Kobokog signature.
That was some third strike low forward. The super action right there.
He gets back thrown out of the pressure.
Yeah, Luffy is just making some very confident decisions here. Oh, and
he
saved himself with Nadeshko there.
Chris has, I think he's answered like one of these drop kicks. They've been hugely successful for Luffy here.
Yeah, Luffy's been rinsing a lot of drop kicks. We're seeing a lot of dash forwards into pressure.
Chris chooses the corner himself. Weird decision, but he does get out.
Chris is still playing patient hooligan. Here. Gets the hooligan throw. So he does have this round pretty comfortably ahead.
Mika only needs one opening. And nice. Nice crouch medium to watch control because
that was a great little string there. You don't see that string from many people.
Final round of this game. Kolbakov.
He's fishing for some counter hits here. Nice.
There we are. There's the answer. Back medium punch.
We need to see that consistently though.
Yeah.
He can't let Mika just get in for free like that.
He can't let her enforce that move. It's not good.
Yeah.
I would like to see Chris maybe DP these neutral jumps, but it's hard. Oh, there you are. You mess up and you get CC'd.
Yeah.
This hurts when you have 900 HP. Reset. Oh, that's done. And that's going to be the game. It's going to be the game.
That is some unbelievable damage to me.
900 HP.
We see it time and time again. Goes for another reset and gets the grab.
Goes for a grab.
I mean, once you're in the mixer there, you know what I mean? It's so tough. So we got Luffy two games up against Kolbakov. This, I think, has been generally the way their matches have gone. Luffy generally has gotten the better of Chris. He's straight back in. He doesn't want to take a second think. I think Chris is playing well. He's playing patiently, but he's just not consistently able to keep Luffy out here.
He's playing the matchup properly, but he's just Luffy's just overpowering Chris here, it seems.
Yeah. Again, a lot of these medium kicks, these crouch light kicks.
I'm pretty sure Kami gets a DP punish on a non-charged dropkick. It is -4, but I mean, if Chris is not doing it, then maybe it isn't, because if anyone knows, Kami information is Chris. Excellent shimmy.
That's an excellent shimmy, yeah.
Nice confirm. On the verge of stun.
Nice.
Excellent Tiger Knee and nice DP.
Even follows on with a bit of damage. Nice, so builds himself a little bit of meter back there. Comfortably takes that round. As we can see, once Kolbakov gets his pressure going, he is in his element, you know what I mean? But against Mika, the primary game plan is just keep her out, stay alive. And that's very tough to do for an entire round.
But likewise, once Luffy gets that opening, he's a monster.
Yeah, exactly. And Luffy is playing this so, so well.
Mika's crouched light kick is just stopping the advance here for Kolbakov.
Yeah.
He is sitting on full super. Let's see what he can do with that. That does represent three potential command grabs.
Yeah, there's an enormous amount of damage in the bank for Luffy here. Nice burn. That's so nice. And this is it. A lot of stun on that.
On the verge of stun here is Kolbakov, and there it is.
Luffy just guesses correctly every single time.
Match point for Luffy.
Or rather, makes Chris guess incorrectly every single time.
So match point with full super. This is a very good position to be in if you're Luffy.
Luffy is looking clean here.
Again, he missed time. Yeah. Oh, does not capitalize on the CC.
Okay.
He at least keeps the corner position.
Kolbakov visibly frustrated when he got counter hit there. Like, he's definitely trying to combat this drop kick, but
it's difficult.
Yeah.
Especially when you're nervous.
Yeah, that time he just goes back to blocking it again. He doesn't want to get crush countered.
Super, and that's going to do it.
That's going to be the game. Unbelievable play from Luffy. So clean, just playing like a monster. We will see more Kolbakov in losers coming up. But yeah, that was great. Crowd doesn't look too happy about that one, Rabs, I gotta say.
Seeing their homeboy Chris lose.
Yeah, Luffy is a well-liked player too, you know what I mean? But when you're on Irish soil.
Yeah, it's gonna be some bias.
You gotta cheer for that boy from Warren Point, Northern Ireland.
So up next we have Mao's Problem X and Epsilon Atrosh.
Here we go, guys. This is gonna be a good one too. I haven't seen much of Problem X playing today, actually, yet.
Me neither. I'm not sure which character he's using now. I think he did go through a phase of using Dictator, and he kind of strayed away from Birdie, but I think he's since gone back to Birdie. So,
yeah, because
we'll
I'd considered his Birdie, like, pretty top class when I saw it previously. So, but we'll find out pretty soon, guys, what's going on with that with those characters.
Shout-outs to Red Bull.
Yeah, shout out
to
Red Bull.
They hooked us up with so much refreshment.
We got some Red Bull swag here this weekend, guys. It's great.
Man, these chairs, again.
We got three more matches on stream, by the way, guys. So hopefully these are all good ones. We got the crowd getting hype here.
These chairs are excellent.
Man, you're bigging up the sponsors. You're trying to get free gear off all these sponsors, aren't you?
Gear.
I know your game.
If you're listening, hook me up. I feel like a James Bond villain right now.
You can, because Ramza, for those who don't know, is the king of like day one combo videos, creating technology in games. So you can make your day one combo video where you with your Vertigear chair showing in the background. You know what I mean? That'll be great exposure.
Hook this guy up.
Drinking a Red Bull while you're doing
shame
it.
Shame the shilling. Yeah, that is.
Shout out.
And guy's just doing a button check here.
Yeah, we got a button check going on. We're gonna get into the game right here in a second.
I'm not sure who Itrosh plays. But I'm pretty sure Problem will go with Birdie.
Yeah.
Or Dictator. Probably Birdie.
I want to see the Birdie. I want to see some cans get
thrown.
Oh,
he does go with
Dictator.
Dictator
with M Bison action here. And then Aatrox just taking his time, putting his headset on, getting comfortable on stage.
Try and get in the zone here. Oh, Aatrox goes with Birdie. So Problem did not want the Birdie Mermatch. I think that's what it is.
That makes sense to me, yeah.
Oh, Kanzuki Beach. Gotta change stage, boys.
Birdie's got some WWE wrestler stats. 7'1", 507 pounds.
Big Show.
That's some Big Show
stuff. Big Show
right
stats.
There. Yeah.
So the guys will change stage. Shout outs to the Judgment Girls from Third Strike in the background.
Is that them? Yeah. I didn't know that. That's so sick.
Yeah. What is that thing in Third Strike where Chun-Li never loses the Judgment? Or
yeah,
something?
Yeah. Because it's supposed to be random, but it must be deceded off. Whatever, I'm not sure. There we go. Alright, so yeah, Birdie won't be throwing any banana skins under the ocean. Can't have that on the Capcom
man, that's not fair. Okay, so going to Brazil, Hillside Plaza. I love this stage. It's my favorite.
This is what I always pick, actually.
It's my favorite
stage.
It's the best
stage. Yeah.
Straight in. Problem against Aatrox.
Here we go. So I'm not sure if does Dictator want to be on the offense in this matchup? Looks like that's what he's going for.
I think so. It's just to kind of rush Birdie down and just don't give him room to kind of get his V skill out and get his get his game going.
Yeah, definitely. That makes sense to me.
Nice air to air. Good awareness from Problem. Oh. And EX Bullhorn, the armor blows through. That's Problem just walking back, just playing this fortress style.
Very patient. Once he got the life lead, and he was happy to keep being aggressive while he had the corner, but once it went back to mid-screen, he's happy just to chill. Oh, and he lands on the projectile.
Man, I want him to release a Red Bull Birdie costume, but like a Red Bull can.
That would be
It'd
so
be
sweet.
Amazing, wouldn't it? EX Head Stomp.
Alright, we had Dictator close to stun there, but Problem managed to fly out of it.
Should be able to kill here. Yes, burns the bar, that is well worth it.
First round, man. That was back and forth, for sure. Round two. Birdie's got some kicks on too, look at Birdie's sneakers.
Oh, just out of range for the blast.
Problem looks
and again,
very comfortable here in the mid-range.
Nice anti-air, Crouch Heavy. Oh, nice read. That was minus, I think, two at scissors. So, plus one here, pressure. Big CC, full conversion.
When I started playing Street Fighter V, like day one, I thought Dictator was the best character in the game.
Yeah.
Like, there's no way to deal
so
with
did
all
I.
pressure.
I thought he was amazing.
Yeah.
Stunned, should be stunned. This should be the game. Birdie and V-Trigger, one bar. Doesn't even need the EX bar.
Aatrox playing very, very well there.
Bison
takes the
round.
Pressure, takes the pressure from Bison and comes back and wins the round.
Yep. Both these guys sitting on one bar and
there's the classic.
EX Free Willy just flies at him.
Yep. That down jab. Very, very good hitbox on that.
Psycho Axe is just. Oh,
that
nice
slide. He uses it to get some pressure started.
This EX scissor kick pressure, plus one on block. Oh, no punish.
This is the punish. I think he was just a couple frames late on that.
And Aatrox is fishing with Crouch Heavy Punch buffers, trying to catch some extended limbs from Problem. Excellent Bullhorn. Uses the armor to blow through. Interesting VR from Aatrox.
Problem looks so comfortable here in the neutral game. I keep saying it, but he's just standing there. He knows his spacing perfectly. He's not scared of anything from Birdie at that range. He's cornered. Now he's going to be scared, though. Oh, Birdie backs off. Aatrox backs off.
He's weary of V-Trigger activation, I think.
Yeah.
That is unsafe.
Problem has got a good hit rate going on these slides. Nice dash for him.
Not reacting to dash.
Gets the gray damage, gets the jab.
Good trade.
First game to Problem.
First game to Problem.
That was a nice clean little sequence there to take the match. I really like that.
when Bison has you in that like EX scissor pressure, it's gonna be very hard to break.
Yeah,
like it's he's just such a good like lame strong offense character.
Hey, Trosh is doing a great job as well when he's cornered and taking those EX scissors. Like he is, his blocking has been pretty good. But like in this game, all the pressure characters are gonna open you up eventually.
That Psycho Axe is plus one. Dictator does have a trace range, so Birdie has to hold that. First counter, Psycho Axe.
One hit off stun. Goes with the EX floor rush. Nice. Oh. Down jab.
Birdie's shin Birdie right now. He's all red.
Looks like he just had had the spiciest Boojum you can get. That's who I want to sponsor me. Shout out to Boojum.
Boojums are top tier.
They've been keeping the Irish fighting game community fed for years.
Red Bull and Boojum.
Nice. And that's another pretty clean round to Problem there. He just fends off the V-trigger. Great, is getting hype here for Problem X.
And Problem is, he's content to just sit there and just... You know?
He is. Atrosh did find a nice dashing grab there. He is exploiting that range now a little bit more. And he gets the stun
here.
And that was all built off that dash forward grab. That Problem X was happy to stand at that range. Atrosh found the way to beat it.
And interesting, the Atrosh corners is down.
Yeah. That was a
pretty interesting choice, but takes the round. And
worked out okay, man. I mean, he was so close. He just needed one hit, right? So...
Problem is sitting on three bars, so...
Yeah, so now we're seeing the adjustment from Atrosh is those dash forwards at close range.
Nice air-to-air from Problem. Psycho Axe pressure. Nice BR. Get off me. CC's the can.
Wow.
Excellent awareness. Problem just wants to hold this corner position. Good BR, but the Psycho Blast still connects and still maintains his corner position.
He's playing so cautious. And again.
Does not react to the EX free Willy.
2-for-2 hit rate on that so far. Oh, and that's the first blocked sweep. Makes it safe. He's still got him in the corner.
But nice air to air.
This is going to be some damage.
Nice. 2-0 to Problem.
Problem's so comfortable here, man. Atrosh is slowly adapting and making this a closer match. But he's going to have to do a lot in this third game.
Something has to change.
Yeah.
I'm not sure if Atrosh has any other characters. I mean,
it's this close mid range that he just can't beat from Dictator.
Like, yeah, Dictator just he holds that range down so well.
So I think if he can do something about that, he's good to go. But it might just be a case where he doesn't have the tools to do it. Nice backdash.
Nice
That's
punish.
The second time he's baited that.
Nice punish on with command grab.
Yeah, we saw that in the first game too. Nice bit of pressure here. Can't really get much off it though.
Oh, slide connects. That would have been huge if blocked, but it does connect. And Atrosh does escape the corner, gets the banana down, gets some of his five a day with that banana.
Shout out to bananas.
Top tier fruit.
Yeah, they're really good. Shout out to new type Irish player. That's a secret.
Bananas.
He does well at tournaments.
Banana tech.
He has a stock of bananas in his bag at all times.
Gets
like
potassium.
Yeah.
Oh, a wake up EX command grab. This does chunks.
I mean, we need to start doing a bit of some random stuff here to take some rounds.
Nice out here. That was buffed in season 2.5 for some reason.
How could you buff it? Wasn't it already amazing?
They changed it somehow anyway. Nice
pull. Very nice. Atrosh is picking up a bit of speed here now.
It looks like Dictator struggles punishing that sweep. This is very minor. Good punish by Problem. Gets Oki. Nice shimmy back there.
He's been so good at baiting those.
Should be stunned.
Yep. Here we go. No meter though. He's going to build one bar. Oh, and he doesn't.
This is huge. Beat trigger. Crouch heavy punch. Yep.
Keeps this pressure going.
EX Devil's Reverse, everyone's favorite move.
Yeah, we're not seeing Problem rely on our teammates though. Wow, and we got Problem going into match point here. That looked really good for Atrosh, but he just couldn't continue the pressure.
Problem on match point here. Looking very confident.
Look how close Problem stands, and he's just chilling.
He's just standing there with his arms folded,
yeah.
like a dictator.
Like a dictator. Nice
air layer.
Gets at a really weird angle now.
Atrosh not taking the bait. And Problem is happy to just sit there. Just lame him out.
This is a masterclass in spacing from Problem, honestly. people aren't usually happy to stand there against characters like Birdie, but he just knows he's got the upper hand.
Just knows his ranges.
Yeah.
Perfectly. That is minus two. That command grab is a legit mix-up. Just walks forward, crouch medium. Great.
Nice anti here. Yeah, again, doesn't really get much off. It just gets just an air reset, crouch light kick. Nice down jabs.
Yes. Oh,
3 for 3 on these. But they're happening so infrequently, it's not making much of a difference. We've got the random bull run.
Get banana down.
V-trigger. Oh, he tries to punish it. Both players safe.
Nice
anti-air.
Just in time. And if that was any later.
And he just slightly misspaces to dive there.
Just one hit away. Oh, double dash he knew. 3-0 for Problem.
That was very, very well played by Problem X. Shout out to Atrosh as well. That was 3-0, but I feel like, again, it was just Problem X just looking slightly on another level there with the spacing.
So, up next, I believe we have Millennium Will 2-Pack,
nice.
Using Laura, I believe, and Meltdown Mr. Crimson, who also plays Laura.
Are we going to have the Laura Mirror, or is one of the characters going to...
I think Crimson has a Dalsim. So
okay, you don't want to play Dalsim against Laura, though, do you?
No.
No.
I would imagine that you wouldn't want to.
I certainly don't want to.
No. So, I mean, I'm pretty sure we're going to get a Laura Mirror match.
Yeah.
So that's going to be the reality here.
I feel like this match is whoever gets it started first.
Yeah.
It's going to be really tough for the other player to come back.
It's just momentum. That's what these characters... Certain characters, yeah, just... They just thrive off
this,
that.
This is going to be interesting, though. I think it, because, like, a lot of Lauras get away with some nonsense.
Yeah.
Some stuff that is not legit.
Yeah.
That's not going to happen in this mirror match because both players are so aware of what's the real stuff, what's the real mix-ups, and what's the gimmicks.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So I think, like, in a way, I'm not sure if that benefits either player, but we could see maybe a slightly more reserved match than you'd expect because of that.
There will be some scrambles. There's going to be some scrambles.
Yeah.
So both players just checking buttons here.
This I like when players do that. They check if the stick still works.
I do that.
Spin the stick around. Well, yeah. Like, you think it's just the buttons are going to work?
I don't know. Better safe than sorry, I guess.
That's true. You're like, oh, my back isn't working.
He is going down to an edge. Oh,
cheap. Are we going to get a blind pick here?
Very interesting.
I don't think we did have blind pick. I think both players just going with different characters. So we're going to see a very unusual matchup here at high level.
They will have to change stage because...
Yeah.
This is the last game in winners top 16, so move on from there.
Here we go, guys. Yeah, so we are gonna see a stage switch here. We have a random select. Yeah, we have another round stage. This stage is so annoying, honestly.
Man, it makes me feel sick. It's so like off-putting or something.
Just like kind of motion sickness type stuff. Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, it's a great idea, but
it's like a Smash stage.
Yeah.
No disrespect to the Smash players.
Like Falcon shit or whatever. Whatever his name is, man. I don't know.
Captain Fox. I mean, there is Fox and there is Captain Falcon.
I don't play Smash.
I think they're two pretty cheap characters.
Apparently.
Yeah. Anyway, we're not playing Smash. We're playing Street Fighter V. Capcom Pro Tour, top 16 at Celtic Throwdown. The winner's bracket, top 16.
It is raining out. We're in the film stage.
It is raining here. This is a very unusual match. I don't really know what I think here.
So Ed is like, he's been explored a bit more. I think I'm Still the Daddy is using him too. A couple of players are taking a liking to him. Nice shimmy.
Seeing some damage here in on Dalsim.
Plus that fireball is plus EX bar.
That shimmy was beautiful, by the way, that last one.
Right, staggering pressure here.
Alright, just gets a bit of space there, uses the V-trigger.
Just gets away from that flame carpet. Oh. Messes up, he wanted medium flame.
Yeah.
Will 2-Pack gets that V-trigger out. Excellent cycle rising.
Great punish.
Great tech. Will 2-Pack is just fishing for that one more touch on Dalsim to seal this round.
Yeah, that trade wasn't what you wanted in the anti-air. Nice jab. Gotta keep those teleports in check.
Yep. Round two. It's like Mika's dropkick. You have to You have to show early on that you have the answer for those.
There you go. Nice jump in. Can't really get a full combo off that, but it's all right.
Mr. Crimson is finally established like this classic Dalsim style of, you know, long range pokes.
It's definitely what you got to do in this matchup. He's doing a really good job at the moment as well. Did use all his meter for that first combo.
Might be, or
yeah.
Still takes the damage, but
not that much though. It's kind of okay, I think.
Yeah, it's okay.
And
nice back medium punch.
Too. Nice.
Nice anti-air.
We have great movement here by Mr. Crimson.
He knows his range.
Hey,
excellent.
That was nice.
Cheeky jump back.
The Yoga Sniper. Street Fighter 4. Not a fierce in this game, though, right?
No, the jab.
Yeah, not quite as good.
It's very good for sealing out rounds, though.
Definitely. That's so important in this game because of the lack of chip damage. It's so valuable to have an instant overhead or something like that.
Absolutely.
Big damage there. Mr. Crimson looking comfortable.
Great VR. Those burns the super.
I think he used this.
He maintains the corner position, though. Should get open here.
Ooh, wake up jab. Maybe he knew that wasn't legit.
And Mr. Will 2-Pack is burning here. Taking gray damage.
Yeah, he's taking a good bit of gray damage here. He can just block. Oh, nice. Gets out of the teleport. And he takes it and loses a good bit of gray health.
Nice meaty slide here. Jump in goes unanswered from Will 2-Pack.
Super delayed grab there. We're seeing how much these players delay their grabs against each other.
And the beast kill whiffs. Dalsim is in the air. He chooses to avoid that. Both players just playing that zoning style, trying to keep each other out. Huge EX fireball here from Mr. Crimson. Nice life lead.
Very patient. Walking forward though. Oh, and he just eats a full jump in combo.
Big jump in. Nice tip.
Even Stevens here.
He just recovered in time to block that EX. Oh, the VR.
Into the grab.
Edge VR has to be hands down the best one in the game. It's the best.
Ed wins. This is a really fun matchup to watch, I gotta say. It seems tough for Sim.
Yeah, it does seem pretty tough. I mean, Mr. Crimson is sitting at the screen. He maybe is just maybe thinking about potential character switch. Round
one. No, I think he's gonna keep going. I mean,
yeah.
The thing is, right? What, he switches to Laura? Then he maybe takes a game, and then he's in the Laura Mirror match, probably.
Yeah.
And then that's the situation I think he wanted to avoid here.
Yeah, absolutely. Nice Gale to avoid the...
Yeah, really good with. Into the meaty slide. He's got the corner. He's got that Dalsim pressure.
Shout out to the ST.
Yeah, we got this Street Fighter 2 Dalsim stuff. It's pretty legit in this game.
Now,
that's how I tried to play Dalsim in Street Fighter 4. It doesn't really work in that game. But it's back in this one.
It's good in this one. And he does miss a drill there. Nice VR.
Yeah, he just wants to take that range back. It's not really working out for him, though.
Good option. Mr. Crimson using that B-skill to avoid the cycle knuckle from Ed. Good throw tech. Great air-to-air. Nice life.
Yeah, Will 2-Pack here really showing off the benefits of having a pocket character like this that people don't know that well.
Mr. Crimson just checking that dash.
Yeah. Here we go, we're on the board. Mr. Crimson's on the board. It's so hard to just consistently keep these characters out, though.
Like, rushdown and aggression is absolutely the style in this game.
Yeah.
It's a thematic thing in this game.
A lot of the characters are designed that way. Even the characters like Dalsim, who are traditionally defensive, they have to give them some strong offensive options, I think, to make them able to
dive kicks, Yoga Gale, etc.
Yeah.
V-skill here is paying dividends for Mr. Crimson. He's potentially eliminating the Cycle Knuckle from Will 2-Pack's arsenal. Just throws the V-trigger out to advance. Just cover his advance. Nice cycle rising.
That was a funny setup.
It's not punished to VR. Big jump in here.
And finishes plate.
And he chooses not to because the Cycle Upper would have whiffed at that range.
Alright, how are we going to see Dalsim try to finish this out? Another instant overhead. Ooh, just trying to poke. He goes in. Desperation there from Will 2-Pack. But I mean, you got to take risks like that. If you're most likely going to lose the round anyway.
I agree.
You know what I mean? You got to take some kind of risk to get back in the game.
Mr. Crimson tying it up here. That is 1-1, correct?
That is 1-1, yes.
Will 2-Pack stay with Ed?
I think you. Oh, no, I think
select.
You go Laura. I think you go okay. Laura. So, I think what you think at this point is, if I go Laura, it's a free win. Then I got to deal with the mirror match. Maybe I lose the mirror match.
And then I can go
then
back.
Then I can counterpack again. Yeah. Counterpick again. Yeah. Okay. That could be the thinking here. I don't know.
That's
the interesting
yeah.
thing about best of five as well. It's not. It doesn't lock you in as much as it does in best of three to try a counterpick.
It adds an extra layer, like of yeah. depth. It adds that dynamic.
And I think you're going to see that more and more as this game evolves. Players are just going to learn more characters.
Yeah.
They're going to have more stuff in their pocket, and they're going to be able to counterpick more.
I mean, shout outs to the guys for using Celtic Throwdown as a testing ground for first to three in pool.
It's excellent, yeah.
Yeah, so I think hopefully more CPT events follow suit and do first to three in pools. I mean, I know the players absolutely want that.
The players definitely do want
yeah.
it.
As far as
I'm sure, I'd love to see a statistical analysis on how much time it adds per game on average. But
yeah.
I'm sure, like, you know, Get Your Tournament, Shedouts, or someone like that has done that. So, but this event has ran super smoothly today.
Yeah, absolutely.
So,
oh, Mr. Will Tupac, excuse me, sticking with Ed.
Oh, okay. So he's got a little fake out there.
So it is 1-1. Nice life lead here for Will Tupac.
Yeah, this is where as Dalsim you got to start going in a little bit. It's not your primary game plan, but you got to work to get that life lead.
That V skill, as I said before, is just seems so good in this matchup.
Yeah.
That EX cycle.
Ed seems like very like a KOF character to me.
Yeah,
quite strange.
Yeah. He's sitting in the fire though, fucking up the HP.
Oh, picks up.
Big confirm on the counter hit, crouch heavy.
This aggression.
Oh, and he messes up the combo. BR, excellent.
He does take it again though. That's the same thing that happened last time.
He fails to punish the recovery on B-scale. And Will Tupac is chilling here. That has to be a mistake. He did not want Cycle Rising there.
I don't think so.
Or maybe he tried
yeah.
to catch a limb or something?
As a great man once said, you hate to see that type of thing happen.
Yeah, you hate to see that go.
But anyway, so we got Dalsim and Randall here.
Mr. Crimson is choosing to forego the V-skill now, going for a more offensive approach.
I think it's working out. I think this might be the way to go.
The main reason he's using V-skill, I think, is just to avoid... it pretty much eliminates Psycho Knuckle from Ed's arsenal, the charge heavy punch. Nice Psycho Rising,
really
nice anti-air.
Nice.
Mr. Crimson backs off.
Yeah, and it's kind of funny. Now it seems like Will Tupac is the one who wants to keep the space away from Dalsim. Obviously, that has a lot to do with having the life lead, which he no longer has. Oh, this is going to be big.
Will he burn the super? He does.
Oh, he goes for a super. Okay.
Nice. Now, Mr. Crimson knows that dash up is not real here, so will he check it? Oh, he tries to fish. Try to CC that jab.
I like that.
Yeah, it's a good idea.
That's the next level of what you were just saying.
Yeah.
That'll beat him trying to check the dash. There we go, and again. This is tough. We do have full V-trigger on deck, so if we can get a knockdown, we can get something going. Do get a grab. Not able to get very much off it.
Oh, and VR just grabs him out of the CA. That's unfortunate, man.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what was supposed to happen there, but losing all your meter going into the third round is not a good place to be.
No, absolutely not. Great spacing here on the drills.
Nice. Plus on all of that.
EX Psycho Whopper, get off me.
Beautiful out here.
Shout out to Season 1. Nice Psycho Knuckle.
Terry Bogard still up here.
Nice VR. Most characters can jump that base skill on reaction, but I guess Sim can't. Maybe he can instant teleport.
Nice, gets the counter hit. Good damage. Keeping the aggression going here, even though he has the life lead. He's got the corner. He wants to keep it.
He knows Mr. He knows Will Tupac. Excuse me.
He's got the stun. Teleport in.
VR,
full combo.
Excellent. Mr. Crimson.
So this is interesting. 2-1 up now. So this is Will Tupac's last chance if he wants to change.
He wants to switch, yeah. Will he stick with Ed, or...?
I think now you go, Laura.
Now you do, yeah.
I think so.
Okay. I think we're going to see Laura.
This is an interesting match. Such a stacked bracket here, guys, at Celtic Throwdown 2017.
I mean, I want to say Capcom Mina, while we're at character select, Mina looks amazing.
Such
a cool character.
It was too soon, though. It was too soon. I believe we are going to see some Mina in action tomorrow in the team tournament. I think she's legal to play in the team tournament.
Okay, really?
Yeah. So
people will bust out their Minets.
Could be, if you guys want to see, could be some of the first Mina tournament action on stream. So I'm actually looking forward to that a lot. We got all the team tournaments tomorrow, guys, for all games. Should be a lot of fun.
I am in the SF5 2v2.
Who's your partner in that tournament, Ramza?
Infiltration.
Oh, well, that's lucky.
Pretty lucky for him.
For him, yeah.
Only sticks with Ed. He did highlight Akuma. Maybe playing mind games with Mr. Crimson.
Yeah, I don't think there's much mind games when you're 2-1 down, though. Like, I'm sure Mr. Crimson feels very comfortable here.
Sticks with this matchup. Again, just...
Round one.
Stage. I love this stage.
Stage is sweet,
too. He's even with that blue.
So many cool animals in the background.
Yeah. Shout out to sheep.
We got sheep, we got bears.
Birdies.
Yeah.
Oh, V-skill.
Nice. Keeps the combo. Can't quite finish it. That's okay, though. He's got the corner. And he's pressuring here from far range. This is a very interesting Dalsim style we're seeing. Nice. Just keeping this pressure going.
Just spacing on these drills has been excellent. No VR. No V-meter to VR that.
Very interesting. As this match has gone on, we've just seen Mr. Crimson get more and more aggressive with Dalsim. I think he just started to realize Will 2 Pack doesn't really know how to fight it, maybe, with this character, you know? He's saying, well, if you can't beat this tactic, I'm just going to keep doing it.
Oh, that teleport.
That's into match point here. He's just... He realized aggression is the way to win. That is Street Fighter V, you know? Like, you want to be proactive, as I said before.
Momentum,
nice slide.
Offense. Very good in this game.
Yeah. And Will 2 Pack is starting to look a little bit paralyzed here.
And as I said before, the V-skill just countering the Cycle Knuckle.
Yeah.
Wake up, Dab.
Here we go. We got a mix-up here.
The Kakri boys. The Kakri
gets it. It's going to be nice damage.
Nice chunk of damage. And the corner.
In
good position, too. Will he go for stand heavy kick again?
No.
No. Ooh, nice anti-air. Nice anti-air again.
Great anti-air. Very consistent here. Ooh, not that time. Commentator's curse.
Messes up when he needed it most.
Oh,
I'm just out of range.
This is it. This could be terrible. Oh. He does take it.
Drago Dragon.
Will 2 Pack needed that clutch Dragon Punch to get back. So, still match point. But,
Will 2 Pack fighting back.
He can survive here. He can survive. It's tough. We do have Mr. Crimson stock with full bar here. So, one hit is going to take half health.
Oh, wow.
Nice sweep. That's some old school stuff, too.
Wow, that was amazing.
The
fireball connects, crazy. VR, man. You can't punish it. It has no recovery. Such a good VR. The VR here. He's able to block in time, but still eats the V-trigger. Good position here for Will 2 Pack.
Intense, guys.
Is that going to work? I think he should be able to land. No, he doesn't. Wow.
It's a one hit here.
One pixel away.
You just need a jab, a grab, an instant overhead from Mr. Crimson.
A slide. Will he slide?
Oh,
he hits
stand
him heavy punch.
That was stand heavy punch. Sorry. Well played, Mr. Crimson. Very interesting. Two Laura players. We don't see a single Laura pick in all the matches.
Was that a 3-1, was it?
3-1, yeah. So shout out to Will 2 Pack sticking to his guns the whole way through that set. Doesn't quite pay off for him, but it's really cool to see some Ed action here on stream. And I don't know, he just he knew what he wanted to do and he stuck with it. Respect. Now we got Dalsim's crazy face here on the stream.
So up next we have Will 2 Pack staying on. Since he isn't losers.
We got losers bracket action now,
up against Ikainu, I believe. Ikainu, a French player, I believe. French Nash in season one. I'm not sure if he's stuck with Nash or if he's changed.
Well, we had one Nash player apparently switching to Jury. I don't think we're going to see another Jury, though. What are we going to see here? This is so action-packed, guys. This is brilliant.
So in the losers bracket now. First match. Millennium Will 2 Pack against Ikainu. Ikainu has no sponsor? Didn't know that.
I mean, he keeps putting up these kind of results. He's going to have a sponsor if he wants one very soon. We are starting to see more European players with sponsorships. A lot of
breakthrough.
We're seeing people travel consistently to events. It's very good for the European scene.
I mean, one thing, people have expressed their distaste for this game, but you can't knock the fact that it's giving people opportunities like that.
For sure, for sure. I mean, esports is just getting bigger and bigger, you know, whether it's fighting games, whether it's strategy games, shooters, whatever. It's just, everything is just growing. And, like, this is the new game, the newest game. This is what Capcom want to promote. And, you know, it's a good tournament game.
Yeah, absolutely. It's great esports. Very easy to watch for spectators.
Yeah, exactly. We got Marvel vs. Capcom Infinite coming out soon, too. Hopefully that'll be good to watch.
So, we are on Kanzuki Beach.
Kanzuki Beach. So we have Laura versus Guile coming up here.
We'll have to switch stage.
So Will Tupac, we're gonna see a stage switch.
You'll be saying goodbye to those beautiful Judgment ladies.
What have they been doing between? Well, I guess this is before Third Strike, right?
So I think so. Yeah,
they were on the beach in Third Strike,
just
and then
chilling, and then
how did they get that job in Third Strike? What happened? You know,
maybe Gil was looking for.
Oh, that's true. Actually, yeah. Anyway, we're going to go back in here, guys, going random again. Hopefully we don't get another banned stage.
Interestingly enough, Will Tupac has said before, I believe, on Twitter. Now, I'm not sure if he's changed his opinion since then, but he said that Laura beats Guile.
Okay, I can see that.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you can get in. She's definitely a character that can apply the pressure, finish the job, you know
definitely.
What I mean? If you can just get in, do that damage.
At Kanzuki Beach again.
Well, this is unlucky. Okay, guys, we're going to have to get another stage switch. Bear with us here. The random number generator in the game is not being very kind to us today.
Nope.
We get to see the Judgment Rings again, though.
Yeah.
Shout out.
And the crab. Yeah. Shout out to the crab.
So here we go. So we are seeing Will Tupac playing as main here. No more Ed. We're going to see if Anya playing Guile. So definitely, he was a Nash player before. Nash was very strong. He knows the stick of a strong character.
Sticking with
the
zoning Sonic Boom archetype character.
See, that's exactly what I do when I play fighting games, you know. I very much respect it.
Yep, absolutely. It's a tried and tested playstyle.
Yeah. So what we're going to see is a pretty classic matchup here. We're going to have Laura trying to get in, Guile trying to keep her out.
And she's in.
Yeah, straight away.
Straight out of the gate, just pushing him down.
And that's brave, you know, jumping in against Guile like 1 second into the round. He just confirmed that Guile wasn't holding charge for flash kick. He threw the Sonic Boom.
Yep.
And then just gets straight in there, gets some early damage.
So I wonder why Will Tupac says that Laura wins. I mean, does she have a good way around Sonic Boom? I'm not too sure. But maybe he could show us why Laura wins.
I'm not sure. I mean, the Sonic Booms are looking pretty effective here. I think it must just be the fact that once you get in, you can just do so much damage.
Yeah.
Stuff going. That was a great
sweep. Nice sweep check on the fireball. Jab anti-air.
Yeah, we're seeing a lot of crouch jab anti-air from Guile players today.
Taking a leaf from the Guile skill. Nice overhead.
That was great. So yeah, we see just using the V-skill Sonic Boom as a shield there, lets you go up, apply pressure.
Cover his advance.
Yeah, exactly. Very, very strong in this game. Now we see Will Tupac start to get something going, but...
Great check on the fireball again.
Yeah, he's doing that on reaction every time, I think.
That's a huge part of this matchup. Just checking those fireballs. And crouch jab anti-air again. And that upside down kick is -2, so... You lose your turn pretty much every time it's blocked.
And this is pretty tough. I mean, Laura does just have to guess to try and get in. We got to jump, we got to dash, you know. Oh, nice! Whiff throw, this is going to be some damage into a mix-up here.
Oki here.
Doesn't get the real scope. Backs
throw,
off.
But
yeah.
Does not capitalize. He maintains the corner position at least. Excellent sweep again.
Every single
sweep
time.
Wheel, though. Oh, nice grab. Sunset wheel.
Oh, and not quite sure what happened there. Do with the V-trigger now. Pushes her away.
This is so hard to deal with.
This looks like some Rainbow Edition stuff.
I know, man. It's crazy. Nice grab on the VR. Kainu taking the first game.
And Guile does have that ability. Not many characters have it in that game. When the enemy character is on chip damage, he can just put them in that Sonic Boom mix-up.
Yep.
And it is legitimately, you have to guess or you're going to die just from neutral if you let it happen.
Such a good offensive tool. multi-pack. Going to character select.
Going to character select. I'm not sure, like, as you said, if you think he's very confident in this matchup, I don't see him switching.
I mean,
unless
maybe he's...
Maybe he hasn't played a Guile who just sweeps him every time he tries to fireball, and he goes, oh, that's bad. Yeah. But no, we just saw a little button config changing there, so maybe there was an error there.
I mean, it was a while ago he said this, so...
Okay.
Maybe his opinion has changed since then, but maybe not.
Sticks with Laura. He does stick with Laura, yeah. I think he is comfortable in the matchup. Maybe something in his buttons was wrong, although he seems to be getting... most of what he wanted. I did notice a couple of input errors.
Maybe just wanted to double check.
Yeah.
Or maybe Seth set a new button.
There we go. We loaded in. Guile the man with the two American flag tattoos.
Couch strong.
Right there.
Laura just slowly trying to advance here on Guile.
Little 2-pack playing a little bit more patiently now.
Ooh, nice buffer.
Yeah, I think... he's more just going to try and get just outside the poke range and then just try and get some grip punishes seems to be the plan now. I kind of just going in the corner there, even enough the light total.
Backs away now. He's Laura some more.
The firm. Great, that was great. And that is blowing up the Laura dash stuff. You can't let her do that to you, so jab into combo.
There's not anti here, VR.
Laura pops her V-trigger,
plus 6. Does not bite on the stand heavy punch.
Great throw, so brave from my Kainu.
Nice jab. He was fishing for a shimmy. Nice air to air. No anti here.
Wow.
Nice dragon suplex. That move is called.
I kind of
from Guile.
That is a good name.
Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of just looking very, very comfortable that round.
Nice
full combo. That's the classic Guile combo. Street Fighter 2 till now.
Comes down with the deep jump in roundhouse. Does not check that fireball from Wiltupac.
Wiltupac just can't find his range here.
He's not anti-airing, he's done.
Yeah.
He has to spam medium punch anti-air or heavy bolt. That's the answer to these jumps.
Akainu is just putting on a masterclass here. This is perfect spacing. His pokes are perfect. His anti-airs are good.
Guile fights so well from the corner. Excellent anti-air. This does not cross up in the corner. Oh, it goes because of double dash.
And Akainu knows exactly what's up, just blocks it, and takes another game.
2-0 to Akainu on the verge of knocking Wiltupac out of the tournament.
I'm not sure what Wiltupac can do here with Laura if he's going to stick with her. Seems like Akainu just has everything just unlocked then, you know what I mean? He knows how to deal
checking
with the
everything,
range.
He's
yeah, he knows how to deal with the jumps. He knows how to deal with the fireball.
Absolutely.
He's playing this matchup perfectly right now.
Wiltupac returns to character select again. Is he going to take a breather or will he switch? Union Station.
He goes Laura again, he goes Laura again.
Sponsored leader.
Yeah, he must be thinking about what he can change. It just seems tough here. I think he was planning on relying on that fireball a lot, and when it gets checked every time...
Akainu sweeps it every time.
Yeah.
So well on checking those fireballs from Laura. Fight. So here we are in Union Station. That London pub.
Yes.
One of my favourite... local spots for a pint.
This is a great stage.
Shout outs to the old guy in the background.
He's the guy with the guitar.
He's holding it down.
Oh, nice flash kick. Okay, we get a little pressure. No, again, he's Wiltupac is playing a patient here. There, he's not trying for any gimmicks. Goes for a throw there, nice neutral jump, but doesn't get a punish.
That bolt is plus 2, so throw is a good option.
Dash forward grab. He's still a Nash player at heart.
Nice VR. Get off me. Nice crouch jab anti-air. Such a strange anti-air.
It's very Street Fighter 2. Very Street Fighter 2.
Very interesting.
Dalsim in that game. Did that all day.
Laura trying to advance behind this fireball. Just VR. Just keeps her out. One more touch will do it.
Akainu just knows this matchup too well. He's countering everything perfectly. So
Akainu on the verge of knocking Wiltupac out.
Ooh, first counter though.
First counter, heavy kick. Switches positions, interestingly enough.
Oh, and we hadn't seen that. That is where the pressure begins, but couldn't get anything off it. Wiltupac just going a little crazy now. Ichirago flash kick for a double.
Flash stops the EX command grab. Nice. Nope, no answer to the jump.
Akainu is, like... I don't think Wiltupac even feels like he's winning this round when he's got the life lead, you know what I mean?
Oh, but he does get some damage here. Fails. One more mix-up.
Throw escape, nice.
He tried to sweep V-Trigger, I believe.
And dash into grab.
Dash him around grab.
Yeah. So we haven't seen much of that. I kind of seemed prepared for it before, but it was just enough to clutch that round. But Akainu here still on match point.
That is huge. Big jump in over EX Boom.
And Laura is doing Laura stuff.
Jumps.
Command grab. His guesses have been so good.
Somebody buy this guy a lottery ticket.
Yeah, seriously. Alright, we get
nice
some damage.
Confirm.
Nice grab. Okay. Glitchy Pack making something happen. He's warming up.
Nice jump back to answer. Just trying to keep her out with these booms.
Yeah, he knows he's got to outweigh this V-Trigger.
By the air throw, I believe.
Another hit. Doesn't punish the throw whip.
Walks out of range.
Oh, he's going to be heartbroken if that costs him the match.
This is so hard to combat. So hard to combat. Oh, and he gets... Oh, knocked out of that flash kick.
So we have Will Tupac on the board here. He really started to get something going there. We saw the Laura mix-up engine begin to work there.
Yep.
So he needs to make that happen again. That was the first time he's managed to do that in three games.
Yeah.
So we need to see more of that this time.
So whatever adjustments Will Tupac has made, it's been working. So
nice flash.
Excellent flash kick. That's like some Street Fighter 2 AI stuff where you do boom, then flash kick instantly.
Alright, gets the damage, can't get anything
nice
off
deal,
the counter
hit. Throws out the beast and tries to bait a jump, but Will Tupac doesn't take the bait.
Oh my god,
excellent.
Kainu's ranges have been so good this whole set.
Does not answer the V-Skill dash, but
BR
is just paying dividends for Akainu here.
Use his only meter there as well. And his V-Trigger.
Nice crouch heavy punch.
Alright, we're getting some damage, we're getting some mix-up. No, can't continue to... He's getting the pressure going. Can't make anything happen.
Akainu's
defense is too good.
One more touch could do it for Akainu here, and there we are.
Akainu is playing out of his mind right now.
Great overhead to see that. Match point again for Akainu.
Nice
interesting trade there in the throwback. Throws out a crouch jab. Anti-air, but didn't lead to anti-air.
I think Will Tupac just needs another dash into command grab, to be honest. Goes for a jump instead. He's going for these lights, but he's not really getting much off them afterwards. Like, in terms of pressure, Akainu just blocks, gets pushed out.
Akainu is making this decision to just use the V-meter extensively for VRs.
Huge combo there.
Seems to be a pretty good idea.
We do have a connection into a reset.
It's air reset.
Yeah, that was so unfortunate. He does get another hit. Akainu manages to jump away.
No answer to the jump.
Empty low. Jump low. It's a
and
combo.
And that's it.
Akainu
knocks Will Tupac out.
What a player, man. Akainu is playing excellently.
That is the end of Will Tupac's run.
I mean, Will Tupac, he might be upset after that, but...
Great showing.
If he watches that match back, he has to just give props to Akainu for playing like that. That was amazing. All right, guys. So that's going to be it for Top 16. We're going to come back tomorrow night. We're going to have the Top 8 of Street Fighter 5. But yeah, so we'll see you soon, guys.
Thanks for tuning in. Bye, guys.